My name is Peter Kleinheit. I'm from Parla Software, but I'm here now as a representative of the GAN PDF workgroup. There I run the specification committee where we define industry standards for proper PDF preparation and delivery. So there's obviously quite a lot of things I can talk with you about PDF. My question, and we are working in the GAN PDF workgroup also about the future of proper PDF handling and future standards. Now, a question in the audience: PDFX standards. Is everyone who is working with PDFX standards here in the audience? Just three of you. That's actually a pity. And which standard, if I may ask, PDFX1?
X1 is preferable most of the times,
yeah.
And sometimes X4.
Mm-hmm.
But we would like to see a standard where you can still have layers in the PDF standard.
So then I will tell you a little bit about where the standards are given. Till now, PDF X1A is actually the de facto standard. Even there is PDF X3 out since a couple of years, and color management would be allowed. A lot of people still refrain from doing color management. Very often the printers rather take CMYK files because they want to take the responsibility. Even then they have the inksetting engines in the background that anyway do all the separation, but that's another story. But very honestly, in my view, PDF X1 is already dead when you look at the creation process nowadays. We have very modern technology in the creation process. People that use color manager objects, intentionally or not, is now another discussion, they are using transparency. And then when it comes to PDF delivery, they flatten everything. They actually destroy a lot of good PDF content on the output side. Printers are more and more struggling because you have stitching when you output such PDFs, and say, what we do today is the same thing like 20 years ago. Except back then we had native files, today we have a PDF, but what's inside the PDF? It's still the same old-fashioned thing. So I really can encourage everyone who can get hands on a new output technology, PDF output technology, to really use it, and also tell the creation side how to create such PDFs according to the PDFX4 standard. It helps on the creation side. The PDFs are not that complex. They are much smaller than flattened PDF files. If you want to go into color managed data delivery is now a second thing. But keeping transparency and outputting the transparency the correct way is actually the way to go. And a lot of problems that you see nowadays are suddenly just gone. A question again to the audience. You just said PDFX4 is your processing already PDFX4 from time to time. I think mainly because of the live transparency. In your case, maybe also because of layers. Would you also allow RGB content media neutral data definitions in the PDF? Yes.
Yes.
Because what we see at the PDF workgroup when we talk to associations, they say, yes, we want to have live transparency because they already realized having the transparency live and being rendered at the output is the proper way to go. But they still don't want to take on the responsibility for the separation process of RGB to CMYK. So we are actually working on two standards now. The one is PDFX4, the classic method, meaning everything is defined in CMYK and or spot color. And the other is going to be PDFX and color managed objects, but only for those objects where color management does make sense. Because in PDF is around already since quite a time, but for some reasons, it never got through to the masses. It has various reasons. I am also supposed to say color management only works for images. and actually only for RGB images. ICC-based color management does not work for vector elements. If you have a corporate color and that corporate color is, for example, 50 cyan, there's no way to define something in 50 cyan in a media neutral way. You might get something at the printout that looks like 50 cyan, but it's not, it's 50 cyan with a little bit of black or with a little bit of yellow, and the human perception is in such a way that someone might say, yeah, yes, it's cyan, but it's dirt. Disallow such PDFs because then you would disallow the designer to use this function. So that would be a warning. But another example, what is definitely an error would be ICC-based gray. When you have ICC-based gray would always be converted to a four-color gray. If you are in inkjet printing, that's not an issue because black is anyway never printed just with the black ink. But in commercial printing, if something is gray, it should just end up on the black-only plate. PDF X4 allows ICC-based gray, but again, in addition, on top of PDF X, again, workbook requirement would then say ICC-based gray is forbidden, is therefore an error. So that is the area we are working on at the moment. All the other quality relevant aspects like minimum image resolution, minimum line width, smallest font size, all those checks still keep relevance. But we also have to face, the printers have to face nowadays, that pre-flighting is not black and white anymore. I mean, it never was black and white, good or bad. You will face more and more the situation that a pre-flight program might tell you there is a problematic area. There might be, or there is a small text in the PDF, and only a human can decide if the small text really might cause a problem in print or not. If there is a small text that is where someone is supposed to read it, it has to be a certain size. But if there's a text because someone used a company logo, for example, and downsized it to 10%, so the final text size is just 1 point. In that case, someone has to decide, is it important that this text can be read or not? There's no computer in the world that can take the decision for you. And I think the future in that is also to have some visual inspection tools in the future where people in a preprint department can very fast way look at objects, look at PDF and decide is it good or is it not good. Because at the end it's always, if something goes wrong, someone has to take on the responsibility, obviously. And creating tools to help the people deciding if something is good or bad, to take on the responsibility or to have a proper tool to pass it on, will also help all of you. Yeah, so much about GAN PDF Workgroup in a nutshell, let's put it that way.
But I have a question.
Sorry?
Yeah. I have a question about layers.
Yeah.
In the PDF